I'm Travers Mackle, joined by Les East with the Baton Rouge Advocate. We're going to jump right to it. LSU's offense, very sluggish all season. It's a topic that you've touched on repeatedly this season. Do they have to come out and show a better performance for this game against Alabama?
Well, yeah, I think so. You know, the big topic ever since the championship game last year was, can LSU throw the ball better and be more balanced on offense? And clearly they haven't been able to do that any better than they did last year. If they don't do it any better tonight, it's going to be a lot like January 9th. So they have to find a way to balance the run with the pass.
How is that? You know, all the fans, everybody who's watching this right now keeps scratching their heads going, how is LSU this bad throwing the football? Their ground game, especially with the emergence of Jeremy Hill, very good, but is there an answer as to why they've been this bad throwing the football?
Well, it's a combination of factors. All the changes in the offensive line have led to pass protection breaking down. Wide receivers are relatively inexperienced. They haven't gotten open and caught the ball well. Mettenberger is still adjusting to the speed of the college game. He's never started before. And then to compensate for the offensive line, they've had a max protect. So sometimes they only have two receivers going out in the pattern. If they don't get open, there's really not a whole lot they can do. So it's been a combination of things.
This game's in Tiger Stadium tonight. It's a special place. LSU plays very well at home, like we all know. Will that play a big role in this? Does that always have an effect, home field advantage?
I think it helps LSU in that they'll be comfortable, they'll be excited, they won't be so nervous. But the road team has won a lot of games in this series in recent years. I think LSU benefited last year in Alabama by getting away from all the hoopla in Baton Rouge. I think Alabama will benefit by getting away from all the hoopla in Tuscaloosa. So I think it's pretty much a wash, but it certainly doesn't hurt to be in Tiger Stadium.
No team in college football looks unbeatable, but Alabama may be as close of a thing there is to unbeatable right now. I mean, they're steamrolling everybody. They beat Mississippi State last week, a top 15 good SEC team, very handily. I mean, this team looks like they're clicking on all cylinders.
Yeah, they clearly look like they're better than anybody else in the country. They've been much more impressive than LSU to this point. But the one wild card in that is they haven't been tested. If they get into a really tight game in a hostile environment where they have to try and make a play at the end to win the game, they haven't had to do that. And first time you try and do that in a situation like this, it might be difficult.
He's Les East from the Baton Rouge Advocate. I'm Travers Mackle. Now back to you.